Welcome back, everybody. This is Charlie, SorterSurvival.com. Today I'm going to do another indoor post for you. It's a little hot and windy outside, and plus with some of the materials I'm going to be working with, I don't want the wind blowing this stuff around. But stay tuned. I'm going to show you how to field load shotgun shells in the event you don't have any fancy factory type or shop setup reloading equipment. So stay tuned and stay with me, and I'll show you how to do it. Okay, welcome back, everybody. What we're going to do today is show you how to, with a few items, with the absence of certain things that you normally wouldn't have access out to the field, show you how to reload spent shotgun shells so you can reuse them. All the way from removing the primer and reloading them. There's different, of course, different size lengths of, I'm gonna be using a 12 gauge setup. So you got whatever rifle whatever chamber your rifle has on your shotgun, whether it be 2 3/4 or 3 inch, it doesn't matter. You can do them both, but it works best. These type of reloads work best if you're using single shot shotguns, double barrel, whatever, versus pump action. So basically, before when you shoot your round, it's crimped at the top already. Once you shoot it, it flares open, and basically what I did on these, I recapped the holes, and I cut the tips off to remove the crimped end of them. You have different types of crimps. You have your star crimp, your roll crimp like this lug has. You have different type of casings. You got your plastic casings with a longer base on them versus a shorter base. This is for like skeet shooting, bird shot and everything. And of course, I'm gonna do a video later on the brass setup here for putting in your survival bug out kit. So basically what I have is a setup. I have containers that hold my powder. I'm using rifle shotgun powder, Pyrodex. This contains a number 7 shot, but basically what I'm going to use, I'm going to reuse some of the shot that I took out of these after I fired them so I don't waste them. What you're going to need is a piece of cardboard or nice strong paper to use overshot cards. This is an overshot card that I'm going to show you how to make those. Piece of wood that you can hammer on. So you're going to need replacement primers. For 12 gauge, I'm using the CCI 209 primers. So you'll need primers to replace the primers that are spent. These are large pistol primers, which will be used for the brass setup only, but this will be in a later video. And basically what I did for hand loading equipment, I went on eBay and I was able to procure a antique style hand loading setup. This probably dates back to the late 1800s, early 1900s. This creates a roll crimp. Basically, the shell goes in here like this. It gets pushed on, and when you turn the end here, it roll crimps the end of your shell for you. I'm not going to be using that type of setup. So basically, I wouldn't carry this in my bug out kit. It's just a little unique thing to show you. This right here, you crimp, sits up to on a desk or something, so you can, it'll set up and you can turn it. But what does come with this that I like is the primer setting tool here. Basically, once you stick your primer into that, instead of using a deep well socket or something like this and a hard piece something put on and then hammered down to seat the primer, you have this little tool right here where you actually put your shell through there, and you take this and you hand crimp it gently, and it crimps your primer in for you, or presses your primer into the bottom of the shell for you. Like I said, this has been fired already because I wanted to fire it so I can show you how to reload it, and then later on we're going to set it up. We're going to go out and test fire it. So this is a tool I will keep with me in my gear. I will keep this with my gear for my bug out bag or survival bag. It kind of came with this setup right here. This is your plunger for your powder. Once you put your powder in there, you tap it down with this. It's made out of wood, so it doesn't throw any sparks. And it comes with this wad cutter tool. This one didn't come with the setup. I bought this. I had to auction this off on a separate website that I saw on eBay. But this makes the this cuts out the wads like this. Basically, you get yourself. I'm using a piece of 2x4 that's cut in half as my hammer, and you basically just hit it right there, and you cut your little overstock cards or your overshot cards out like this. And so we'll be using these later on in the video. Then you'll need something. I got an old socket that will allow the shell to sit on top, because you're going to need that to punch the primer out. And I had to hand make this. I think I saw it on another post on eBay. Looks like one came with another setup, but it was already bid on and won, so I made one. But basically, this goes down in here like this, and you punch out the primer. So you need those two tools right there. Then you'll need something to measure with. I took one of these little coin collecting holder tubes, and I put little markings on here for my 3-inch shells, for what I want loaded on them, and for how thick the wadding should be between the powder and the shot, for the other side, the two and three quarter shell and the 3-inch shell. So this is what I use to measure my shot and my powder with. Like the bottom line is for the powder, the next line up is for my shot. And then if you don't have one of these tools for punching the primer out, you can use a regular punch like this, but you kind of have to center it and punch it out using that tool. Next, you'll need what I've seen used before, which I think I'll incorporate, is a glue stick and a lighter. That's for when it comes to the end of topping off your shell, you'll need that. And of course, I get a spoon for dipping out things with. And then I use a container like this, which will if I can get it open. Okay. This right here will hold my primers. I can keep the primers in the box, or I can put them in here, or I can put the spent primers in. Whenever you remove your primers from this, keep your primers, because I'm going to show you another video on how to reload. You reuse your primers as well, using that and matchsticks. The see what else I got in this box. Okay, then I got my two containers that will hold my potter and my shot, and then a box to put everything in. Okay, so basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to, for wadding material, I'm going to reuse the wads that I took out of each shell. This one came out of small one here. This one came out of the longer one. You can also use, as wadding material, you can use similar thickness of shot cards. They're actually called over powder cards. They're made out of some start with a nitrate, something like that, but I don't have those. You can use sheared wool from sheep and stuff down in there. I've seen that used because it doesn't burn as bad when it comes out the end of the barrel. So let's go ahead and get started. Basically, once you've fired your round, you want to remove, this one hasn't been shot yet. Of course, you see the primer. On this one, I haven't fired it yet. But on this one, I did. So I'm going to pop this primer out, show you how to pop it out. Move some of the stuff to the side. Okay, take your socket or whatever you're using for punching out. You'll need a rubber mallet or something, or piece of block of wood, or antler billet, whatever you're going to use, and basically you're going to pop out your primer. Primer's out. There's a spent primer. Okay, that primer I'm going to keep. Now what we got to do is we have to replace that primer with another one. So I'm using CCI 209 shotgun primers. Okay. Like I said, you can either place it down in here and then using something solid with a deep well socket with an extension on it that will go around just about the inside of the shell and then slightly tap it so you don't set it off. Or once you put that primer in there, it sets. You have access to one of these tools. Of course, always wear your goggles or glasses. Okay, I got my glasses on for this. But as long as you're not slapping it or anything and causing a concussion on it, it'll work. But just take it and crimp it down. Then it's set. Let's put that out of the way. Next thing you want to do is add your powder. Okay, this is my 2 3/8 chambered shell, so I'm going to use what I have set up for that. Basically, take my top off. Take a little piece of paper, make a homemade funnel. Powder. I'm spilling it all over the place here. Okay, basically it's going to be overfilled. So basically I'm just going to eyeball it to that line. There is measuring equipment to do this exact, where you just dip it and pour and it's ready to go. I'm going to be acquiring that in the near future for my kit, but in the meantime I'm using this little setup. As you can see, I have it to the line of the powder that I use for this shell. And you just pour the powder right down in there, taking your wooden dowel here, Press it down in there. You're good to go. Take your wadding material. Like I said, I'm reading these. You can buy these in any sporting goods store that sells gun reloading equipment stuff, and you can put that in your kit as well. Or like I said, you can carry your sheep wool or any type of wadding material like that you can use. I've even seen cotton balls used for this. So next you place that down in there. Give you a little dowel rod again. Might be a little thick. Forgot. Since I didn't fire this, I cut the rim off. You're going to have to, if you're going to reuse this, you'll have to shorten it up a little bit because I cut that much of the top off. So you can take a pair of scissors to modify this. Press that down in there. You want to get it pressed good down in there so that the powder is pretty well set. But you don't want it too tight that there's no air, because the powder has some kind of air in between it to help. Oh, look at that. Surprise! I do have a pen. This right here I made. I didn't know that. Well, I just learned something. It's on the other end of the thing. Cool. Well, I got an extra one. I'll use that because, like I said, this is kind of antique, so I don't want to really mess it up. What do you know? Okay, next set. Setup or step here is to use... Where are those pile of beads I said I was going to use again? Oh, here they are. Okay. No, they're right here. Okay, these are number 6 shot. You can use, this is 7.5. This is basically for skeet shooting and for small game, you know, like quail, dove, and everything. A little bit bigger is good. 6 is good for rabbit and quail and birds as well. So I usually use the average of number 6 shot. This is what came out of it, so I'm going to actually put this back in. Okay. Should have got me a better funnel for this. It might be a little bit more. Like I said, I did cut the tip of this off. So you're just going to fill it up to the top, just barely enough to where you can get your shot card, overshot card in there. Okay, I had to take a little break there for a minute. Okay, back to getting my... Okay, next step. We're going to do, clean this mess up a little bit, is add our overshot card. Overshot card goes on top. Need a little dowel pressing rod there. Everything pressed down, nice and snug, not too hard. Next step, And this next step is very dangerous because we're going to be striking some fire now. So make sure that you have your powder out of the way, your containers are closed, nothing can go boom on you. So what we got to do is we got to find a way of keeping that in there. Now, if you're in the woods and you don't have access or you run out of your glue stick, you can use pine glue. If you go to my website, swordsurvival.com, there's a post there that shows you how to make your own pine glue, and you can use that the same way we're doing this. So we're going to go ahead and heat the glue stick up a little bit. Yep, let me get my piece of paper here so it doesn't drip on the counter here. Okay, once it's melted enough, we're going to get it in there, and we want to put it around, dab it around inside, make sure it gets on the walls. And what I like to do before it gets too dry is I like to put another shot card right on top so that pushes that glue out up against the side of the walls, makes a nice air tight fit. Of course, you know, this is cardboard, you don't want to get this round wet. The glue stick will help keep it kind of waterproof inside, but you don't want to take any chances. You don't really want to shake this around, throw this around in your box or whatever. Take care of it until you get ready to shoot it. Set this aside, let it dry, and it's ready to fire. So we're actually going to go out and fire this once we get finished here. So there you have it. Very, very easy to do. This one has a number 6 shot in there. The number 4 shot, which is a larger pellet than a number 6. This is for shooting a larger game like duck, turkey, things of that nature. And this was the wad that came out of it. If you notice on the side here, I made markings for the different thing wad, because this see the thickness in between, in between here and here is the thickness of your wad, because your shot goes down in here. This is part for the so I took and I measured that, so that gives me an idea how thick my, if I can see it on the side there, how thick, I can get in the camera there, how thick my wad is going to be for a specific shell I'm using. So the wad that I put in here was actually a little bit thicker because it didn't have as much shot as this one had, or as large as the beads are. So this one I can actually reload. I'm going to pour this shot into my box here because I can reuse it. Pour those out. This is already, I didn't fire this primer, I just cut it open so I can show you the different lengths. So let's go ahead and reload this back up, and we'll test fire this when we test fire the other one. Okay, get my powder out again. My powder is going to be for a 3-inch shell, so I'm using the other side this time, but I got specifically marked for 3-inch shells. Just put enough powder in there until I think I'm there, and then if I'm overfilled, oh look, that's perfect. I can go ahead and get that, put the powder in there. I'm gonna go a little faster this time on this. Set all this side here, it gets a little messy. Tamp my powder down a little bit, gently. Okay, I'll need to cut my wad down just slight smaller because of the material I took off when I took it out. It's gonna make it a little bit longer than a shell. And what you can do, if you got a shotgun, let's say 12 gauge shotgun that's chambered for 2 3/4 length shells, which is the small ones here that I'm sitting right there, and you happen to find the 3-inch shells, empty shells laying around, pick those up because you can actually take it and cut them down to the size you need them. You won't be able to, you know, this one will shoot in a 3-inch barrel and a 3-inch chamber and a 2 3/4 inch chamber. This one cannot shoot in a 2 3/4 chamber because it's too long. It'll have to be cut down, but it will shoot out of a 3-inch chamber. Just a little tidbit there for you. Okay, let's put our wad down in there. As far as we go. This tool is actually exact diameter of this. It's made for different type of wadding than this plastic one. That's why it's a little tight for me. I'll have to, if I'm going to use these plastic wads, I'm going to have to make me another tool. Or I can use this to press it down in. Okay, next I got to measure out the amount of shot I need, which is on my line there. It may take a little less because I had to cut this. You can actually, what I do, this is about the amount that came out of it. Since I got to put the shot card in there, I'll have to remove a couple beads like that. Won't hurt a thing. Recap this bottle, get it out the way. Put my shot card on there. Like so. Ran out of shot cards, so I'm gonna have to make me one. Here's one I was working on, so I'll base it. Let me put my top back on my bottle. Let me get that out the way. Safety, safety, safety. Go ahead and cut me one out. Okay. Now when it gets in there, you just stick your finger in there or something there and then push right on out. So there's a shot card, overshot card, or ready to go. It doesn't take very long to reload one of these. Very quick. Very quick. Like I said, keep my fire away from there, dummy. Okay. Alright. Put my glue in there before it dries. Stick me another shot card on there. Press it down. Seating very nicely. Remove the excess. And there you have it. 3-inch shell with number 6 ready to go. I'm sorry, number 4s. And this is a 2 3/4 with number 6s ready to go for test firing. They've all been primed and ready to go. So, let's go get an area set up and test fire these bad boys. Be right back. All right, this is Charlie. We're back. I'm going to be, if I get myself in the camera here. Hang on. I'm going to be using a single shot, a breakdown 12 gauge. We got both the rounds that we reloaded by hand, field expedient method. I'm gonna use the smaller shot first, make sure it goes into the barrel, goes in pretty good. What I'm gonna be shooting at, let me see if I can zoom in on it for you. Right down there is a can I'm gonna be shooting at. So I'm gonna try to get in front of the camera here. Hopefully you can get in the field of view. Okay. There's one shot. Pops out like it's supposed to. Next one, a 3-inch. Chamber's good. Ready to go. Like a charm. Let's go ahead and take that one out. Again, once you shoot them, keep them, save them, because I can probably reload this over 6, 7, 10 times maybe before it gets wore out, and to save you some money and for survival expedient purposes. Make sure eye protection. I should have had my hearing protection on. My ears ringing a little bit. Forgot how loud these things shoot. But this is a field expedient method of reloading your shotgun shells. You can do rifle shells, pistol shells the same way, different size, all kinds of different size stuff. Just you need the equipment to do it with, and gather it together for whatever firearm that you're going to be using the most. Because whenever you're out in the woods or in a what they call a shit hit the fan scenario, and you don't have access to a store, but you got access to powder and shot and empty holes and primers and things like that, you can field load your own holes and keep reusing them. Save you a lot of money, and it's there for when you need it. So this is Charlie, SourceSurvival.com. Stay prepared, stay alive, stay safe. Come back soon. Mm-hmm.